afternoon, guys. Just wanted to do a stash update here. This will probably be the last stash update now for the year. I've been doing some Christmas shopping to me for the past couple of weeks. I actually picked up as well one of my old grail kits, not one of the ones that I mentioned in a response to Al Wood's video. When I made that video, I had already decided to buy this kit, so I didn't add it in there. But anyways, we'll get started with a few small things first. I picked these up over at Michael's. Usually around this time they'll, or at least I find, that they usually start putting things on sale, even though it's not Christmas yet. So these happened to be on sale the other day, so I picked up those. They have LED lights in them. And while I was there, I also noticed this. You can see it's a rock and brick wall. It's a roll of, I don't know if it's adhesive on the back or not. But I decided to pick that up. Thought I might be able to do something a bit interesting with that. I also got a box of bots here from I think it's Firebird Design. Sorry guys, I'm just checking here. Fireball Model Works. So I just got some resin stuff, just some off-road lights. I'm not going to take it out of the box unless anybody wants to see it. You can let me know in the comments. But it's just some off-road lights. Bought a roll cage for the Ford Bronco. Some cab lights, door handles for my Blazer build, just stuff like that. I picked up this kit. I picked this up. I think I'm going to build. Any of you guys watch Trailer Park Boys? I'm going to build Julian's Firebird using this. At the same time, picked up another one of these. I built one of those before, but they seem to be getting a little bit scarce. Michael's a few weeks ago had their 55% off. Bought another one of these Barracuda kits. And I also picked up this kit. I think this is a new repop, recently reissued. Pretty cool truck. Picked up one of those. For anybody who watches my channel from Canada, I found this really good online hobby store. They're in the prairies, I think either in Alberta or Manitoba, one or the other. Called Hobby Sense, I think. I'll put the web address up here on the screen. But I find their prices are really good. They have everything. You can buy Dragon, Meng, Tamiya, Trumpeter, anything. They have huge range of kits, a lot of tools, paints, wooden models. Really good store. They also have free shipping if you spend $250 before taxes. But even if, I know that's a lot, but even if you don't get to $250, their flat rate shipping in Canada is $9.99. So doesn't matter how much you buy. That's just what they charge for shipping. Like I said, their prices are really good. They have quite a few sales on, it seems, a lot of times. And their shipping is actually pretty fast. I usually get it here in Newfoundland in about a week, week and a half, which is actually pretty good. As well, I've only gotten two orders from them so far, but they always throw in pipettes. It's a really nice fine tip paintbrush. So two orders, I have two of these now, so that's great. But the kits that I got from them, I got this Ruined Garage. This is a 1/35th military scale, so I have an idea for a small diorama. So I have a few other kits coming that will go with this to make that diorama at some point. They had a sale on a lot of these truck kits, $45, I think, which is pretty good. I bought this particular one here. I want to build the truck from Maximum Overdrive, the Goblin truck. So apparently this is what it was. It was a white Western Star truck. Just give me 1 second. I'll show you the Goblin head that I got for this. Just give me 1 second. There you go. So I bought this, I think maybe last year. I showed it in one of my stash updates. This is a resin Goblin head for that truck. You can see it's kind of profiled a bit. It's going to take quite a bit of work, and I'm not too happy with the paint. So we'll be doing a little bit of work on this, but also it should be glossy finish because it's a fiberglass piece on the truck. So that's what will be going on that white truck there, or that white Western Star. So, sorry for that, guys, a bit off topic there. They also had this one on for $45. It's the Peterbilt Wrecker. And this next one wasn't on sale, but I've been wanting this one for a while as well. It's Freightliner. I actually want to build the Pork Chop Express out of this from Big Trouble Little China. Probably going to end up making the decals myself. I'm going to say it's probably been 2 years that I've been looking for decals for that, and no luck. So probably going to end up making those myself. So that's the idea for that kit. This next kit, I'm going to have to take the camera away because it's a very big box. Like I said, this is a grail kit of mine. I've been wanting it now for quite a number of years. Not hard kits to find, but they are pretty expensive. And a little sidebar on this one, the cheapest one I could find, of course, was from China. So it was free shipping, and I was a little bit antsy about spending that much money buying something from China that had free shipping, and it seemed a bit dubious. But anyways, I went and took the chance and ordered it. And surprisingly enough, about 2 days later, I got an email from the guy in China. And he was like, "Oh, we shipped your kit. And by the way, it happened to be in our warehouse in the US. So we're shipping it from the US. It turned out that it came from Vermont. But I was a bit surprised that a Chinese seller would have a warehouse in the US for eBay. But anyways, I guess it turned out that he did. And it certainly came wrapped like it came from China. I mean, it was waterproof. It was just nothing but a bunch of tape and styrofoam. But anyways, guys, no rambling. Let me pull this off here and I'll show you this kit. Okay, guys, so here's the kit. It's the Leopold railgun. This is the trumpeter version, 1/35th scale. So it's a very large kit. It's about 3.5 feet long when it's finished. It has about 1,200, I think a little over 1,200 parts. So it's a pretty involved build. Dragon also makes a 1/35 scale version of this. I did a little bit of looking before I bought this, and apparently the trumpeter one has a bit more detail, and as well the trumpeter one gives you two versions or two ways you can display it. You can display it just on a straight rail, or you can kind of see it in the picture here. The way they used to aim it was they would have a cross section of track, and they would put one truck on one track, the other truck on the other track, and then that way they could adjust the gun for firing. I'll put up a picture here at the end to kind of show you what I'm talking about better than the way I'm trying to explain it. But you can see it's a large box, and it's a very deep box, and it is filled right to the top with plastic. So like I said, it's a kit I've been after for a while. Easy enough kit to find, but a bit expensive for a plastic kit. But when you look at the size of it and how much plastic and photo etch and stuff there is. So that's another one ticked off the Grail list. I'm probably going to update my Grail video that I put up probably 2 or 3 years ago and kind of revise it, put up a new one. So anyways guys, thanks for watching, and if this is the last video I put up for the year, just like to say Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to all you guys, and hopefully we'll be back in the new year. So thanks for watching, and hope you stay tuned for future videos.